Now, welcome to Electrical Machine 1 lecture, lecture number 5. Today's topic is equivalent circuit of transformer. In a previous lecture, it has been discussed that the winding has some resistance, it has some leakage reactance in primary side as well as in the secondary side. So under such condition, in the loaded condition, the transformer has some drop, voltage drop across resistance and reactance in primary as well as in the secondary winding. The primary current is comprising of exciting current, or it is the no load current I0, or it may be written as IE, no load current or exciting current, plus reflected current in the primary secondary current, that is I2 dash, isn't it? So these will make the total current is I1, which already explained with the help of vector diagram in the previous lecture. Okay, now our topic is a equivalent circuit of transformer. So in the equivalent circuit, we can draw the equivalent circuit of a three-phase induction motor as well as a transformer. It is used to analyze the performance characteristic of transformer. What are the different losses and behavior of the circuit? So in design purposes, suppose if someone is going to design the transformer and it he has developed the equivalent circuit. So by modifying the equivalent circuit parameter, different analysis can be performed, or different analysis or performance can be determined before practically, or before say physically designing or manufacturing the transformer. So it helps in design application of the transformer. It is used for analysis purpose, and it become quite simple. In the last lecture, we discussed that the primary resistance can be referred or can be transferred to the secondary side. Similarly, secondary parameter, that is maybe the voltage, the current, resistance and leakage reactance, can be transferred to the primary side. It is only for the calculation purpose, for easy in calculation to determine the performance of the transformer. Okay, so similarly, here we are going to say draw an equivalent circuit of transformer. Now, in case of transformer, the primary side, the current is the no load current, or it is the exciting current. In the last lecture, we use IE is the no load current. This no load current is comprises of two component. So IE is equal to IW, that is a core loss component, plus magnetizing component IE. So where IW is the core loss component. It will compensate the core losses in the transformer. And I mu is the magnetizing current. Magnetizing current, whose responsibility to produce the required magnetic flux in the magnetic core. Okay. Now, in some of the books, or some of the, say, it can be nomenclature as IC, it is a core loss component, and I mu is the magnetizing component, is IM, and whereas IE can be replaced by I0. This is the books, some of the books, or some of the times, we use such type of notation, where I is the no load current. So IE, or it may be written as I0, is the no load current, and IC is the core loss component, and I mu can be represented as IM, is a magnetizing current. Okay. Now, this core loss component and magnetizing current is a shunt current, and it represented in the say resistance. Say this will represent the resistance because it is a losses, whereas it will represent some excite reactance it is in a parallel branch. So we can write here, the core loss component is IC, which is equal to voltage applied to the transformer is V1 divided by the current. Sorry, this is not. It is the represented as a loss, core loss component. So we will write as a R0 is the representing the core loss resistance or core loss component, which is V1 upon IC. It is in ohms. Similarly, reactance X0 is V1 upon IM. It is in ohms. So either it may be written as a RC, it may be written as a RM. There is no problem in writing the notation. So our equivalent circuit, our circuit become, it can be represented as, this is the resistance, primary resistance R1, reactance X1, and primary number of turns is N1. And exciting voltage or supply voltage is V1. Whereas the total current is I1, current drawn by primary source is I1. It has two components, the component which is due to the load current in the secondary winding. It is the counterbalanced MMF due to the current I2, reactance and resistance in the secondary circuit, load resistance or load impedance is there, number of turns is N2. So this component, the component which we want to draw is the exciting component. Which comprises of a parallel branch of resistance and reactance. So this is resistance and this is reactance, which represent the core loss and magnetizing current. So this current is I0. The current which is flowing, it is IM, and current flowing resistance is IC. The resistance is R0 and X. And XM or X0. Okay. So this is the exciting or no load current components, which can be represented in the term of resistance and reactance and this one. So this is the somewhat equivalent circuit of a transformer. It is on the primary side and it is on the secondary side. Now, in the previous lecture, we discussed that the resistance and reactance can be referred to the primary side or LV side or HV side as you wish. Let here, we want to refer that resistance, resistance R2 and X2 in the primary side. So it will become R2 dash is equal to N2 upon N1 bracket square into R2. Similarly, the reactance X2 dash is equal to N2 upon N1, sorry, this is, we are going to refer in the primary side, okay. So N1 upon N2, bracket square R2. Similarly, reactance X2 dash is equal to N1 upon N2, bracket square into X. Okay, so our circuit become is like that. Resistance of primary winding, resistance of secondary winding, reactance of primary winding, reactance of secondary winding. Okay, so here it is R1, R1 dash, R2 dash, X1, X2 dash, and exciting component is as it is, resistance, reactance, it is X0, R0, this is no load current I0. The component is I1. Okay. Now from this one, it is a I2 dash. Okay. So this is the here it represents the load resistance or load impedance ZL dash, where ZL dash similar to this one, it is a N2 upon N1 upon N2 bracket square ZL. And here it is the V2 dash voltage referred to the primary side. Now here it is as it is, voltage is V1, and V2 dash is equal to, it is N1 upon N2 into V. It is not a bracket square. So it is only because we have equation as V1 upon V2 is equal to I2 upon I1 is equal to N1 upon N2. So V2 is equal to V2 dash is equal to the V1 upon V2 into V2. So this is the some equivalent circuit referred to the primary side. Now here two resistances are there, two reactances are there. So it is quite clear, or it is quite simple to add these values. Now this values is say R1 is equal to R1 plus R2 dash, which is equal to R1 plus N1 upon N2 bracket square into R2. Similarly, X1 is equal to X1 plus X2 dash is equal to X1 plus N1 upon N2 bracket square into X2. So this total resistance and reactance can be added very easily. So here the resistance and reactance get added, whereas the exciting component will remain as it is. So here it is a reactance, resistance, X0, XM or X0, R0, no load current I0. It has component which represent the magnetizing current I mu or IM, and here is the core loss component IC. Okay. So rest of this one is simply it is get added. Resistance R1, reactance X1, which is referred to primary side. And here it is a ZL dash and it is V2 dash. So it is the equivalent circuit referred to primary side. Equivalent circuit referred to primary side, or it is a primary side. Now, the same can be reversed. That is, the same things can be transferred to the secondary side. So in the secondary side, written as, can be written as R2, it is the equivalent resistance referred to the secondary side. So it is R2 is equal to R2 as it is, R1 dash, which is equal to R2 plus N2 upon N1 bracket square into R1. Similarly, X2 is equal to X2 plus X2 dash, which is equal to X2 plus N2 upon N1 bracket square into X2. Okay. So now here the total resistance and reactance, equivalent resistance and reactance. So can we write as a equivalent resistance referred to secondary side. Secondary psi. Similarly, equivalent reactants referred to secondary cell. Now, this component, shunt component, it has to be referred into the secondary side. So R2, we write as a R2 dash, or it is a R2 simply, it is a R2 dash, which is equal to N2 upon N1 bracket square R0, and X0 dash is equal to N2 upon N1 bracket square X0. Okay. So now our equivalent circuit become it is the exciting component as it is means it is referred to the secondary side. It is R0 dash X0 dash, and whereas the resistance is R2, reactance is X2, the voltage is V1 dash, or it is equal to V2. Okay, and this is the load resistance or load impedance is added as it is, because already the load resistance or load impedance in the secondary side is Z. So our discussion is that the equivalent circuit can be drawn, referred to the primary side or referred to the secondary side. It has a characteristic is same, definitely should be same, because it is a linear transformation. If the value of referred value, if the values of referred resistance and reactance is something wrong in doing calculation, suppose there is a mistake in writing N2 upon N1 or N1 upon N2, definitely under such condition, the calculation may be wrong. But if you do, the concept is that the resistance of LV winding, when it is referred to the secondary side, its value should increase. Why? Because in the HV side, the number of turns is more, length of more, and hence the resistance should increase. At the same time, the current in the HV winding is low, so it will give the same power loss which is going to occur in the LV side. So power should be invariant. If the power loss in the resistance R2 in the secondary winding is different, and the resistance when it is referred to the primary side or LV side, the losses is different, the transformation is wrong. Okay. Now, many times the component of current, this no load current, I0 is nearly 5% of full load current, 5 to 7% of full load current. The reason is that it has only the iron losses and the magnetic flux, which is a close magnetic circuit. Whereas if suppose we consider the three phase induction motor, there is an air gap. Second is the rotating part. So windage losses are there, windage and frictional losses are there. So the no load current of induction motor is higher as compared to the no load current of transformer of same capacity, isn't it? So here the no load current is very small as compared to the load current. Sometime the equivalent circuit is for the primary side. This is the equivalent, most say equivalent circuit, approximate equivalent circuit is just resistance, reactance, and impedance. So we will omit, or we will just not consider that shunt component. So that current is I1, referred to the primary side R1, X1, and ZL dash. So this is the referred to the primary side. So under such condition, the voltage, V2 is there. So we can write as V1 is equal to voltage V2 dash, it is referred to the this one, plus I1 into bracket R1 plus G X1, isn't it? Same thing can be referred in the secondary side. It is just similar. It is the resistance, reactance, and load impedance. Load impedance is V2, R2, X2, and ZL. So here V2 is equal to, or E2, here is the EMF induced is E2. Okay. So here E2 is equal to V2. This is the voltage across load, terminal voltage V2 plus into bracket I2 into R2 plus J. So the equivalent circuit can be drawn either referred to the primary side or referred to the secondary side as per application or as per the need to do some analysis in the this one. So this is the simplified, equivalent circuit of a transformer. What is the application? Application is to determine the voltage regulation. Application is to determine the performance. If suppose after designing it is found that the copper losses are higher, so in this case the winding, length of the winding, the cross section of the conductor, quality of the copper grid, copper grid is by replacing we can reduce this one. Similarly, if the flux, leakage flux are more, so there may be a sandwich winding. Sandwich winding is that to reduce the leakage magnetic flux, we found that there is a method instead of using only sphere cross-sectional area of core. Let is the AI is the net iron area, net iron area required, and A is the gross area. Gross area is somewhat greater. Why? Right? Because the core is laminated, and in between the lamination, in between the two strips of the iron material, there is a lamination, it is varnished or paint is there. So there is some stacking factor is there. And if you do the winding over this, it may be LV winding or HV winding, to avoid the sharp bend, because if there is a sharp bend in wire or cable or winding is there, it will give the local heating. So under such condition, the core is a zero potential. So first we will place the LV winding. First we will place LV winding. This is LV winding. And after LV winding, HV winding is placed. So it has an advantage already discussed. Okay, the point is that if you place the HV winding next to the core, there is a thickness of insulation resistance, and it will increase the mean diameter. It will increase the mean diameter of winding, which will increase the resist, which will increase the length of the conductor, and hence resistance and losses are there. Okay, so this is the HV winding. Outer side is the HV winding. In case of HV winding, we will provide some tappings, number of tappings to control the voltage. So tap. If you provide the HV winding next to the core, it is difficult to bring out the connection of tapping, isn't it? One thing is there. This is one more difficulty if you are placing the HV winding next to the core. Now, our objective is to reduce the length of mean circumference, length of mean diameter or diameter of the windings, bobbins are there, and to reduce this gap. So instead of using only the square shape or rectangular shape, the core is a crucible core. So net iron area will remain as it is. Only the shape of the core is defined in such a way that the net iron area will remain as it is. Only diameter can be reduced with the help of stepped core. Okay. So there is a steps are there in the core. And after that, there is a circum circle on this case. So under such condition, the area will remain as it is, net iron area AI is as it is, but the air gap with the crucible core, it get reduces. Now we will place the LV winding as usual, then HV windings are there. So it will reduce the mean diameter of winding bobbins are there. So it is called as a crucible core. And this crucible core is used to reduce the air gap, which will reduce the leakage reactance. It reduces the length of the copper conductor or winding, which reduces the resistance and hence the copper losses. And sometimes this HV winding and LV winding plays on the same limb. It's a sandwiching type. It may be some LV, then HV, then LV and HV. It reduces the leakage fluxes and leakage reactance. So by this modification, by doing some equivalent circuit, analyze the equivalent circuit, what are the parameters, what such type, which type of parameter is more, optimize this parameter to obtain the performance, best performance and best design cost of the transformer. No doubt, if you use a large number of steps, okay, so the circle become more and more smooth in the shape, but it will increase the labor cost and say cutting cost are there. So it is the best compromise between the electrical performance point of view as well as the cost of the manufacturing of the transformer is going to decide the number of stamping, number of steps in the crucible core. Okay, so this is the somewhat about equivalent circuit of transformer. Now, what do you mean by voltage regulation? The voltage regulation of transformer, it is the similar to the DC generator and DC three-phase induction motor, three-phase alternator voltage regulation. Voltage regulation is the change in terminal voltage from no load to its full load. Means how much is the voltage drop across no load to full load. In the equivalent circuit or say in any circuit of the transformer, this is say primary winding. Okay, it is connected to the source. It's connected to the source is V1 and E1 is there. Rest of the writing component I'm just omitting only for our simplicity. This is the resistance and reactance. And this is the terminal voltage is V2 across the impedance ZL. Okay, so this is the voltage, it is the E2. So there is a gap, there is a difference between E2 minus V2 is nothing but the voltage drop across resistance and reactance. Okay, so this resistance and reactance drop is whenever the current flow through the winding, there is a resistance drop, there is a reactance drop, and this is the difference of this one, which is expressed in the percentage, is called as a voltage regulation. So percentage voltage regulation is the difference of voltage drop, difference of EMF induced under no load condition minus terminal voltage and EMF induced, it is the voltage across the load is the terminal voltage divided by V2 multiplied by 100 is the percentage voltage regulation. So the voltage regulation of transformer is defined as the arithmetical difference in the secondary terminal voltage between no load, that is when the current is I2 is equal to zero, and the full load when the current I2 is equal to the full load current, whatever the full load current, at a given power factor with the same value of primary voltage for both rated load and no load. It is expressed either in per unit value or percentage value. So the condition under which the regulation is to be figured or regulation is to be determined is, what are the conditions are there? First condition, the rated voltage and rated current frequency. First is the rated voltage, current, and frequency. the frequency, the rated voltage should be there, rated current should be there, then and then it is figured or it is going to calculate the voltage regulation. Otherwise, means whenever there is a nameplate readings are there and it is written as a voltage regulation is 5% or 3%, it means that the voltage regulation at rated current, okay? When the regulation is rated without a specific reference to the load condition, the rate is to be understood. If suppose only it is written as the voltage regulation, percentage voltage regulation is 3%, it means that it is at the full load condition. Waveform of the voltage should be assumed sinusoidal. Our assumption is that the voltage regulation is whenever it is written, the voltage wave shape or the current wave shape should be a pure sinusoidal. Next, the power factor of the load should be mentioned. Say, voltage regulation at what percentage of what, at what type of power factor? So percentage voltage regulation 3% at unity power factor. Suppose it is 5% at 0.8 lag power factor, and it is minus 3% at 0.8 leading power factor. Means the regulation which is written on the nameplate or the regulation which we are going to define or determine, it should be specified what would be the, what is the rate, what is the load on the transformer. Either it is a 50% load, either is a 100% load, or under which condition of the power factor, either it is a unity power factor or pointed lagging, pointed leading, or whatever it may be the value of power factor. So it is necessary to define the voltage regulation at these conditions. That is, load on the condition, what would be the load, 50%, 100% load, voltage regulation at defined power factor, because it is going to differ. The voltage regulation of transformer as unity power factor is minimum, whereas as the power factor decreases in the lagging side, the voltage regulation get increases, and at a unit, at leading power factor, the voltage regulation is negative. So today we will stop here. In the next time, we will do the some, we will drive some equation for the voltage regulation under lagging power factor and leading power factor, and their analysis voltage regulation of the transformer.